Have you tried WinForms in .NET 9? If you haven't, you're missing a huge update that can help you write better apps. .NET 9 now includes Roslyn Analyzers specifically for WinForms. Now, I know what you're thinking. Who is Roslyn? Who asked for her help? But if you've been writing C# or even Visual Basic for any length of time, you've likely been experiencing the Roslyn compiler platform without even realizing it. Many of the times you see those squiggly lines in Visual Studio, whether it's a refactoring suggestion, a code fix, maybe an error, that's Roslyn running behind the scenes, reviewing your code and providing suggestions. But in .NET 9, we're getting our very first set of Roslyn analyzers and code fixes specifically for WinForms. Those analyzers are in there to help you with stability, performance, and even your productivity. The first analyzer is focused on the new async APIs for WinForms. But because it's new, the team wanted to make sure analyzers were in place to make sure you're using the APIs correctly to prevent future issues, for example, with your async code. One of the first things you're going to have to decide if you're using those APIs is which overload of the control invoke async method to use. Each one provides different combos of sync and async methods, some of which return a value and some that don't. But if you select the wrong one, you'll likely experience instability in your application. Now, I'm not going to go into the details of how to use that invoke async method correctly. That's a video for another day. But I will leave a link in the description below to a blog post that goes into it in a lot more depth. So without diving into why it's an issue, let's look at some code to see the analyzer in action, pointing us to the correct overload. There are some really great examples of the analyzer in action in that blog post I mentioned, but if you're converting an older WinForm to .NET 9, you're likely going to see a lot of errors and warnings. You might have to handhold some fixes to make the analyzer happy, but in some cases, you're going to find that there are also code fixes already waiting for you. For instance, say you've built a custom user control, but you haven't added any methods to control the code DOM serialization of properties, or more simply put, how the designer takes what you've designed and converts that into C# or Visual Basic to turn that into a form in your actual app. Because remember, unlike .NET MAUI or WinUI or WPF, there's no intermediate language like XAML to describe your design. So when you are making changes to a design, opening up a new form, it's converting C# or Visual Basic back into that designer look. And then when you save, it's going to convert it back to C# or Visual Basic. But therein may lie some security issues. Luckily, there's a code fix to help speed you up. Have it add the designer serialization visibility attribute to your property. Heck, you can even have it fix the issue on the entire document, project, or solution ride. Pretty sick, right? But we all know that analyzers aren't perfect, and luckily there are several ways that you can change the behavior for an analyzer or turn it off altogether. For instance, you could wrap the line in pragmas to disable the rule for that line, or add them in a suppression file for your project. You can even add them as an attribute of your offending property. And you can also change the severity in your .editor config file. So do you have an idea for a WinForms analyzer? That's the best part. The entire Roslyn platform has a great API where you can add your own. But your idea might be something that could benefit all WinForms developers, so you should consider contributing to the WinForms GitHub repository. I'll leave a link in the description so you can join in on the fun. But don't worry, even if you don't have a WinForm analyzer idea, the team still wants to hear from you. On that GitHub repository, you can create new issues, submit bugs, test things, contribute code. There are so many ways to get involved, and the team would love it if you helped us make WinForms even better. Until next time.